Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, I am going to give you tips regarding how you can improve your soft skills, how you can speak in English fluently, and how you can be so confident. Okay, so coming to the first thing, how you can improve your soft skills. Soft skills in the sense, they play a very, very important role coming to your career. Okay. So you should always learn all the soft skills, be good at them and all. And one of the soft skill is communication. Okay. Most of the offices, like 100%, like 99.9% of the corporate offices will have a rule that you have to communicate in English. Why? Because there will be employees who come from different parts of the country, different parts of the world, and sometimes out of the country also. So they may not know your local language, they may not know or they may not understand your mother tongue. That's why learning English and speaking in English is one of the most important criteria and the soft skill which you need to learn. So the first thing is, coming to English, first of all, remove the fear of learning English, because coming to English, it is not that hard language or difficult language to learn. It's very easy. The only thing you need to have is the passion. You just need to be confident, and here you go. You can happily speak in English during presentations or seminars, any other things. Okay, just be confident. I'm going to give you a few ways where you can easily learn English without any difficulty and you can be a pro in communication. Okay, so the first thing is, whenever you wanted to speak to any other person, please start communicating in English. I'm talking specially in office. When you wanted to talk to some person, please start talking in English. It's okay if you make mistakes, if you make grammatical mistakes, if you are unable to speak comfortably, it's fine. Please don't let these things drag you back. Okay, please don't suppress yourself. You can still go and you can still go forward and start speaking in English. Please start communicating with in English with your friends. That too, with your friends, tell them why you started communicating in English, so that they'll know the motto of your behavior, and they will not make fun out of it. Okay, because they know that you're trying to learn a new language. Okay, so the second thing is, start watching English movies. Okay, start watching English movies. English, like Netflix, everything, start watching in English. Okay, and if you don't understand any word while watching or while coming across any other word, go to dictionary, happily search the word, note down the meaning somewhere, and every day at least twice read the word and the meaning, so that you can happily memorize the word, so that you can learn a new word as well as you know the meaning of the word also, which really helps you in the long run. Okay, and the third one is, read English. Read English means buy English newspapers like Deccan Chronicle, The Hindu. Please go and read every day. I'm not asking you to read the entire newspaper. At least read one page a day, and whatever words you're not understanding or whatever words you're not comfortable with, just go note it down somewhere, write its meaning, and keep reading it every day. It really helps. Okay, so the fourth thing is public speaking. Most of the people will be very nervous in order to speak in public. Okay, they'll not be comfortable in speaking in public. What these people should do is, whenever you have some events happening, whenever you have some special occasions happening, just go onto the stage, and stage is all yours. Just go there, speak in front of everybody. Just don't care whatever comments you get, whatever happens, just don't care, because You're a great person because you're on the stage, okay? The people who are sitting under the stage, like in front of you, let them comment because they are watching you and you are the performer, okay? If the person who is commenting has that much talent, they could have been on the stage, right? Not sitting and clapping. So don't consider anybody. Most of the people will be jealous because they can't do it and you're doing it. So they'll just be jealous and they comment. Don't just go through that. Just let it go. Be positive. And next thing I would like to suggest is just be confident. Whatever you do, just be confident during seminars, PPTs. What you need to do is confidence builds up your motivation. Like if you have a motivation, in order to succeed that, in order to achieve your goal, confidence really helps you a lot. Okay. And so these are the tips which I would like to give you. I hope this video really helps. I'll be making spoken English classes videos. So if you haven't watched my videos yet, please go and watch. Links will be in the description below. And also don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, like and share the video because the family of Best Way to Study is going to reach 10K subscribers soon. Please join in our family of Best Way to Study. And if you want me to do more and more motivation videos or personality development videos or any other videos which will be helpful for you, so I would love to do them. So please go ahead and comment in the comment section below, like what videos you want me to do next, what videos you want me to make. And I also I have so far done many CRT videos which will be helpful in order to grab your interview. So go there, go and watch all my videos, which will be really helpful. And how to answer HR questions, how to handle the group discussions. All these videos are on my channel, on our channel. So please go and watch. Please don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, like, share and comment. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. All the very best for your interviews, offices, whatever it might be. So just be confident and go ahead. Thanks for watching.